Hello everyone, I'm Umang and we are back here with yet another video for your CAT tips. It's time for the last leg now and I'm sure you are all done with your preparations and everything. You are as excited about your CAT as we all were last year this time. So let's hear it from our ManDevIan about their CAT stories and how did they hold up well on that day. So guys, could you please introduce yourselves?
Hi, I'm Wuzmal.
Hi guys, I'm Bhavya.
Hi guys, I'm Rahul.
Hi everyone, I'm Ashima.
So Ashima, let's begin with you. And do you have something that you can share with our aspirants over here? Like, what was your D-Day story?
Yeah, so one advice that I would like to give to everybody is that, first of all, I think everybody should get a good night's sleep. And it's really important to be well rested. And it's very important that you don't try to cram anything new or learn new concepts before the D-Day.
Yeah, it's really important to know when to stop. So you do not have to revise now. You've done your preparation. Let it be. Have a good sleep, have good breakfast, do what works for you. So for example, I do not take breakfast, I just take a glass of milk before I go to any exam. So do that only, do not focus on what do I have to do before the exam.
Absolutely.
Just yeah, I think you've touched upon a very good point. It's very important to have those 7-8 hours of very good sleep.
Yeah.
And it's not that you've gone to the center quite worked up and there are like baggages in your head that you have to do this many attempts or this sort of
strategy. Yeah, exactly. It's really important that you are feeling good before the exam. So I would suggest whatever works for you, right? So maybe watch sports, have a good go out with your friends, maybe watch a movie. I know it's difficult to do so, you all are really panicked, but trust me, it is what you need to do right now.
And please don't write any full length mock on the last day.
Yeah.
Just relax.
Yeah.
What I did was I had a notes fully prepared and I just used to like refer to it and just refresh all the concepts which you have done so that you should be good.
So other than that, so when you reach the venue, there are a few things that you need to keep in mind. So do not keep things for the last. Be prepared for your essentials, all the documents that you have to carry, have a time buffer, and pee before you go there because you have to make sure you do not have to go to the washroom in between the exam.
That I believe is a very good point that she has touched upon here, because CAT themselves, they also have their own regulations. Like you can carry this, you cannot carry this, you must have this and all of that. So do you have something like something happened with you or anybody you know or you are aware of anything?
I would actually like to comment upon that. So what happened with me on the D-Day was that I forgot my hall ticket at my home. And my exam center was actually almost an hour away from my place, so it wasn't an option to go back. So I think in that situation, what is really important is that first of all, you do not panic. It can happen to anybody. So what's important is that you have that buffer time, like Wuzmal mentioned. So what you can do is you can locate a printer, you can get your hall ticket printed. And this can happen to anybody. So that's completely fine.
I'll tell you my story. So my exam center was located some 1.5 to 2 hours away from my place, and I have motion sickness, so I was really concerned that I would end up puking all the way and then on the exam day. So I was really tense about it. So how I tackled with that was I asked my brother to accompany me, and we talked about random things, not about the exam at all. We talked about songs, we listened to songs so that I don't feel the way that I would have otherwise felt.
So I think it's very important to cross check the exam center that you're actually going
to
like give your exam. So it's very important. I remember the story of my friend who actually had this exam center at Iron Digital Center. He wasn't sure whether it's 1, 2, or 3.
Yeah.
And he actually ended up at a center that was 3 kilometers from his actual exam center. And it turned out to be quite problematic because he wasn't actually keeping any buffer time as well.
So if you can, you should visit the center one day before the exam.
So as we know that it takes 2 to 3 hours to actually go to the center and get your documents verified and for the actual exam to start. So all of us, most of us get fatigue. So to reduce the fatigue, what I would suggest is to reduce the amount of cognitive decision making during the day. You can do that by making sure all the documents are ready, all your clothes are ready, so that you're just on pilot mode during that day and don't make any decisions or any screw ups during that day.
So as we're talking about the exam center as well, I believe while I was appearing for CAT, there was a lot of noise and disturbance on the CAT center as well. So how did you guys get accustomed to the place you were allotted, and how was it like? What was the feel like? First timers, I believe, or the second or third time, but the experience has to be new.
I think what is important that you realize that the external environment really doesn't matter, because you've prepared well, you just need to concentrate. I know it won't be as able to concentrate. It's a new place, so you're not as familiar.
Mm.
Even though you go to that place one day prior to the exam, you won't be as familiar to with your own bedroom where you sit and give a mock. But you have to be okay with that. You just have to focus on the screen that is in front of you and forget about everything else.
Absolutely.
And I think you have to trust the process that all this exam is going to. It's just another day of your life, and it's not actually the day that is actually going to define who you turn out to be.
I don't even like the fact that we call it a day. In fact, I want to add another point to it, is that don't carry any baggage with yourself.
Absolutely.
So, I'll tell you my story. I had a drop year, and what the baggage with me was that I have to perform well in this exam. But I think keep it away from you. When you when you exit your home at that particular day, forget about it. It's just the exam. Enjoy the exam.
Absolutely.
Talking about general exam tips, what kind of tips would you suggest?
So one thing I would like to mention is, so what happened last year was that a lot of people found the quant section really tough. There was a lot of buzz going on that, you know, it was unsolvable, people won't be able to crack it. So I was in slot one, so I appeared, and while I was writing my paper, I was very panicked. I was sure I won't be able to crack my CAT, I'm going to screw up this section, everything. So, but it's really important in that time to remember that if you are finding it difficult, other people are also probably finding it difficult.
So, Ashima, just to add to your point, we know that last year the pattern had changed a bit.
Absolutely.
So, in the VRC section, we had five passages instead of four. So, how it helped me was, I actually took 1 or 2 minutes before the exam to actually go through the paper so that I was not shocked, and it helped me pace through the exam, and I started with my strong points so that I can gain momentum and not get stuck in one tough passage.
I think Rahul has touched upon a very good point over here. Like, it's very important that you actually go through the section once, and if it's imperative that in sections like LRDI, where picking the right set is of utmost importance.
And to add to your point, even if you end up picking up the wrong set, you wasted 10 minutes. I understand you would have wanted it not to happen, but then forget about it. You still have another 45 to 50 minutes. Focus on those minutes and do not. So, for example, all of us, you would have by now set your strategy for the exam. So stick to your strategy, do not make last minute changes, but even if your strategy doesn't go as you had planned, be okay to improvise.
So I believe while we are talking about the sections as well and what goes in our mind as well, probably we should take each exam section as independent exam themselves and not carry the baggage from one section to the other, and just take it one thing at a time and we'll sail through it probably. That's probably, we will all agree upon
as
that as well.
So to give you an example, one of my friends who is studying in this college right now, so he had performed really bad in one of the sections, but ended up, because he was able to keep his calm, ended up performing really good in the next section, and overall percentile was really good. So you have to understand that even if one of the sections hasn't gone as you had planned, it's okay. The next section will be your section. You will ace in it.
And if you're someone who's actually taking the exam in slot 2, it's very important that you do not get into that
Absolutely.
Slot 1 versus slot 2 debate,
Absolutely.
Which definitely goes on, because that is the first thing you check out after going out of the exam center. How was general student feedback? Whether the number of questions that I've attempted is good enough, calculating that mock score that you're like actually going to get out.
This actually goes on for days, like not just that day, but people keep on calculating in this and ends up in no good result for anybody, like just troubles
and
your head
and
nothing.
What you can do is, like, you can just divide the exam into 3 different sections. And if you are doing well or bad in one section, just forget about it. When you go to another section, take 10 or 15 seconds to just revamp yourself and reset yourself, and don't get complacent or don't get bogged down due to one section. It might turn out to be very good at the end.
So some of you who would have an exam in slot 1, you will, if you will go through the reviews in the slot 2, you may have some kind of prejudices. So don't get into that. Stick to your strategy.
That's right. I believe we all understand that keeping your own temperament at its pace is very important, and keeping your calm is the bottom line. So do you have any like parting concluding tips to share with our aspirants over here?
I think my only comment is that you should believe in yourself and you should keep faith in all the hard work you've put in, and you will ace it.
And my final tips would be just be at your best, be relaxed, keep your nerves calm down, watch some feel good movies, watch sports which you like, and you'll definitely ace the exam.
So my advice would be just keep doing whatever you've been doing throughout mocks. Do not try something new, do not try something out of the box. Even if the pattern changes, just stick and believe your instincts.
I think I would like to say keep your baggage at home. You've done well, believe in yourself and have your A game on. That's it.
Alright, thank you so much guys. So I guess this must have helped you a lot, and probably you are going through a lot of discussions in your own head with your own friends, what to do, what not to do, and how are you going to conduct yourselves. Probably this would have helped you, and we hope that you do ace your exam as well as we could manage to do somehow as well. All the best for that, and hope to see you soon. Thank you.